I always love to roll up my sleeves. Not because it looks cool, but because if I don't, this is what it looks like. It's really hard for petite women of any height to dress themselves. And if you're under 5 foot, then it's double harder and triple harder. And let me explain to you why. I'm wearing a regular size sweater. I'm 5'2", and regular size clothes are made for women about 5'5". All right, but it isn't just like 3 inches difference. It's like from here to here. Is it really a big deal? Just because I'm 3 inches shorter, and this is what it looks like. If you're like me, 5'2", maybe once in a blue moon, you can find a regular size clothes that you can get by with, like maybe a dress, a skirt, something like that. But if you're 5 foot and under, that is another story. But don't worry, I got plenty of tips on how you should style, how you should dress if you are under 5 foot. Make sure you subscribe and give me a thumbs up. The first thing I want to say is that don't buy clothes from junior department. Just don't do it. Unless you are junior. If you're a teenager, fine. If you're 20s, maybe. But if you're 30s and above, unless you're getting sweatpants, sweatshirt, t-shirt, anything you don't care looking like a teenager, otherwise, don't buy it from junior department, because junior department are designed for teenage girls. So if you're not looking to come across as a teenage girl, don't go with those frills, girl designs, laces. Just don't do it. Now, if you're looking for sweatpants, do it by all means. If you are under 5 foot, most likely the petite size clothing will not work well on you either. And here's why. Petite size clothes are made according to the measurements of petite models. Petite models, typically they are 5'3 or 5'4. If you are 4'11, you are 4 to 5 inches shorter than the petite models. So I'm afraid the petite size clothing will not fit you that well either. And this is probably how a petite size sweater will look on you if you are 4'11. And this is how a petite size pants will look on you. Now, don't even start with the regular size clothes. Just don't even bother. How does a regular size look on you? Honey, can I borrow your sweater?
Sure.
See, I don't even have something to show you what it looks like. I had to borrow a sweater from my husband, but you get my point. It's just ridiculous. It looks like this. When you're 5 foot tall and you are wearing clothes that's designed for women that's above 5'5". So don't even go there. Make friends with a good tailor. That is really important if you're under 5 foot tall. That means pretty much anything you buy off the rack from the stores, you need to make some alteration to it. Now, I do understand sending it to a tailor sometimes can cost a lot. There's an additional $20, $30, up to $50, sometimes even more to make alteration. But that's totally worth it. Very expensive piece of designer clothing, no matter how much you spend on it, if they don't fit you well, they will not look good on you. They will not look expensive on you. So if you are able to tailor it, the two most important areas that petite women always have problem with, one is the length of the sleeve, another one is the length of the pants. If you pay attention to those details and make sure they are well tailored, then that will make anything you wear look so effortlessly expensive on you. If you are under 5 foot, you should always elongate. And how do you do that? The best way to elongate is to wear monochromatic style. Monochromatic style, yeah, that's right. So when you wear monochrome, that does not mean that you have to wear the same color from head to toe. Common misconception, whenever we talk about wearing monochrome colors, people first think that, oh, that means I have to wear the same color from head to toe, or maybe I have to wear black from head to toe? That's not the case. Well, if you wear the same color from head to toe, Yes, that is monochrome. But you don't have to do that. But you can also wear the same color scheme. Like this one, the sweater and the skirt is not exactly the same shade of blue. But because they are from the same color scheme, that still gives you very flattering monochrome look. And if you're under 5 foot tall, this is really important because you always want to form an unbroken vertical line. And that is the best way to elongate your body and make you look taller and slimmer. You also want to wear one piece. One piece, I'm talking about dresses, jumpsuits, rompers, anything that is not separated. When you're wearing one piece, it's very hard for someone to judge how long your legs are. That is a secret. That is why if you're under 5 foot tall, if you want to appear longer and taller, you should wear a one piece, and that will make it very hard for someone to know where your waistline is, where your legs start, and where your torso end. 4'11 or under or 5 foot tall, it's really important you should be wearing dresses. You should be wearing dresses all the time, all year long. The reason is because whenever you wear a dress, the dress has a continuous repeat pattern or the same solid color from head to toe. That is super elongating, and that is really, really flattering for a short girl. And the longer your dresses, the more effective they are to elongate you and make you look taller. Not a dress girl, you just want to wear separate a blouse and a skirt and pants, no problem. But you want to make sure the color scheme are not too much contrast. If you're wearing a top and bottom that has very high contrasting, then you're basically drawing attention to where the top and the bottom separates people to notice how long your legs are. So, you know, that's why it's really important. You should try to wear top and bottom of very similar colors. Wear pointed toe heels. Okay, you don't have to wear heels, but you have to wear pointed toe shoes because that 1 inch of difference on the toes makes a whole world of difference when you wear them. Look at these pair of shoes. They're not even heels. They're basically just flats. But when you wear, the toe shape is pointed, it elongates your legs, even though you're wearing flats. If you can wear pointed toe heels, of course that is the best. But otherwise, if you want to wear flats, go pointed toe. If they wear pointed toe, it's just not comfortable. I hear you because I have wide feet too, so it's hard for me to find the pointed toe shoes that fit my foot. Find those made of leather or suede. They're stretched enough, and that's how you make sure they're comfortable. Next, I want to talk to you about the ankle straps. Ankle straps is really a dilemma for petite women, and especially so if you are under 5 foot tall. The reason is because most of us have smaller feet, and if you're 4'11 or under, most likely you are a size 5 or even smaller. So that means it's kind of hard to walk without ankle straps, at least in my case. But I do want to let you know that ankle straps are not the most flattering design for women with shorter legs. And this is how it looks like on us. It kind of looks like our legs are cut off by that horizontal line. Now, I'm showing you the same pair of shoes, but I'm just hiding the straps so that you can see the comparison. Now that you removed ankle straps, and now there is no horizontal line to make your legs look cut off. That is much more flattering and just makes our legs look much longer. What if you have to walk in ankle straps? This is my strategy. I go with something like this, something very similar to our skin tone. It's much less noticeable because they will blend with the skin color. That's why it won't make your legs look as cut off compared with other ankle straps. Now I want to show you and you can see the difference yourself.
Choosing the right shoes is very important for petite women, and it's especially critical if you are under 5 foot tall. Watch this video. I talk about how to find the best shoes to elongate your legs and avoid shoes that makes your legs look cut off.